everyone. Why don't we stand? We're going to sing the first Noel together. Hands.
There's a lot of gifts wrapped up in ribbon, but nothing like the one wrapped up in cloth. Darkness, light has come, and his name is Jesus Christ. What a joy, what a joy to receive this gift of life. Lift a shout, make some noise. Shine, and all the world will know. submarine. Better than an Elsa dress. Even better than a pair of roller skates. Better than a new chess set. Better than a foot-long Toblerone. Better than a snow machine. Even better than a big fat turkey roast. Better than the world's best thing. Lift a shout, make some noise, and praise the newborn king with all your voice. Trumpets out,
and welcome to St. Peter's. My name is James and this is Lizzie, and it's great to have you here with us. Happy Christmas, I guess we can say that now, can't we?
Yeah, happy Christmas everyone, and happy Christmas to those watching at home. It is so good to have you with us online as well.
Who's excited for this morning?
Oh, that now, doesn't sound like you're very excited. Who is excited for this morning?
Now, I've seen lots of sheep. I think I saw a panda. I've seen a donkey. I've seen lots of characters. Lizzie, what's the plan for this morning?
Oh, well, the plan for this morning, we are going to be tracking through a story from 2,000 years ago.
Ooh.
Oh, yes, we have some very special, very young actors who are going to be taking us through so we can give them all the encouragement that we can, that we can.
And they've been practicing for years.
For years, building to this moment. Yes, exactly. And then we're going to be singing a few more Christmas songs, and then we are going to be hearing from our friend Hannah. We're going to be hearing from our friend Hannah for a little bit, all in 1 hour.
Wow.
Wow.
That's the plan. Should we do it?
Yeah, let's do it.
Let's go.
Jacob. A scepter will rise from Israel. Description of the Messiah. This is no ordinary king. He will be the savior of the world. I mean, that does sound pretty exciting. And yet, strangely, here we are waiting. In praise.
a cool song. Where did you hear that?
Yep, I wrote it myself.
You should copyright that.
Ugh, now I'm hungry. It's cold, I'm hungry, and I have to sleep in a tent tonight, which I hate. Unless it's at Focus, of course.
Of course.
Camping is great at Focus. Okay, let's regroup. What do we know here? That you are hungry and you don't like sleeping in a tent.
Oh, come on, I wrote this all down. We're looking for a big star, and not in an X Factor way, like an actual star in the sky. And we aren't gonna find it just looking at the floor. Here, take this and have another look.
Okay, okay. That's Orion's belt, the plough.
Yeah, that's Old Man's teeth.
Ice cream lady.
Jacob's ham sandwich.
You've got the lens cap on, haven't you?
Oh, so it is. How embarrassing.
Sounded like you were watching the Grand National.
Ugh. Fine, I'll do it. Okay, I see a big tower. It's right in the middle of the city, in the middle of a green. There's a clock on the tower. Beautiful building. Shame about the scaffolding, though.
Think I'll just use my phone.
Your torch is on.
Oh, it's reveal time. Smile, everyone.
You smiling in this moment is the least real thing I've ever seen.
Hello, 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 hello. Hello, 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 hello.
Hold on. Is that?
Is what?
It's got the right dimensions.
Dimensions? It's huge.
It's the star. Woo!
So, what now?
Well, we just need to pack our bags and head towards the star.
Wait. That star is 25 trillion miles into outer space. What do you mean, head towards it? This is your plan.
He has a point.
Guys, relax. They don't call me wise man number one on this script for nothing.
The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living of a land of deep darkness, a light has dawned.
Wow, can we give that scene a round of applause? All the actors in that scene. Didn't they do well?
Aren't they incredible? Oh, doing so good. Now, one of my favourite things about Christmas is when everybody plays, you know, Christmas games, and there's about 2% of the room who want to play the game, and then there's about 98% who doesn't. We're going to do that. Lizzie and I would really like to play a game, and you're going to be involved. Lizzie.
Okay, the way that this is going to work is we are going to split the room into two halves. Okay, so everyone on this half, give me a wave. Oh, wonderful.
Good participation. That's not all.
Team one, okay? And then can this side of the room give me a wave? Woo!
Well
yeah,
done.
And sound good. Effects as well, I love it. You are team two. Now, at the very back of the room, I believe there are some stars. Are there some stars? Team, give me a wave. Great, I'll explain, and if they're not there yet, they will be. So, what we're gonna do is these stars need to make it all the way from the back to the front, okay? And we are going to collect them in our very festive Santa hats, okay?
Oh,
and so
I
between
see.
You need to pass from chair to chair. You could make it like really wide and get
no.
them down quickly.
We've got it wrong.
Oh, we've done it.
They're not at the back
of
the...
Do you know what? Who needs that? Okay, so different game altogether. Okay.
No, sort of same game but twisted, slightly different. The stars are out there, you just don't know where they are. And we're all gonna find them. So we need one leader from each team. Oh yes, you'd be a really good leader. Come forward.
Come on, Alicia.
Okay, you are now Team Alicia. That's way better than Team One. Team Alicia, why don't you give it up for Alicia?
Okay, and we need someone from Team Two. Who's gonna be a... Oh, yes. Come on down, Josie. Yeah, Josie, come on. There we go.
Okay, you are now Team Josie. Give it up for Josie.
Okay. Now, under your, or hidden in the room, oh, I might have given you a clue there, there are 10 stars, okay? Ooh. And so, what Alicia and Josie are gonna do is they are gonna run round, collect up your 10 stars.
Here, have my hat.
And collect them in the hats and bring them down the front. There you go, Josie.
So you might have already found one. Don't show
okay.
anyone yet.
You might wanna put it in the air. Are we ready?
Team Alicia, are you ready?
Team
There's
Josie,
real prizes.
Are you ready? Okay, 3, 2, 1, go!
Oh, Alicia, there's some over here.
Okay, I'm gonna encourage you to stay in your seat so they can get to you. That would be most helpful.
Josie is hurdling over people.
10
Alicia's
stars
got,
each.
Oh, I think Alicia's got 4, maybe 5. Wave the stars if you found them.
Okay.
Oh, I can see one up there. There's a really high one. Oh, there's a couple over there,
10
Josie.
10 stars each. Bring them down and we'll count them up.
Yeah, this is exactly like a classic Christmas Day game. The idea really good, the practical reality. It's where it begins to fall apart. I don't know, how long do we let this go for?
Just a few minutes.
Okay, you got 15 seconds to see how many you've got. Have you got 10? First team to get 10 and bring them up
Quick,
to us.
Bring them down.
Okay, hey, Team Alicia!
Team Alicia, well done, Josie, you are so close.
Oh, well done, Team Josie as well. Everyone wins.
It's Christmas.
Yeah, that was exactly like a Christmas Day game. Fun at the start, sorts of drags on a little bit too long, but we'll bring it back. Lizzie, what's next?
Well, we are gonna continue our story, and so what we would love for you to do is just imagine.
Use your imagination.
Just use your imagination. Imagine if there were real camels.
We don't have real camels. Oh
imagine
my goodness.
Imagine if there were real camels joining us today.
Real camels, where are the real, I think they might, are they gonna come in the back? There's some real camels.
Some real
somewhere.
Camels.
Oh, I can smell them.
Use those
them.
Imaginations.
I can smell. Oh yeah. Are they coming in the back? Are they coming in the back? Where are they? Can anyone
hello.
See the camels?
Anyone see
can
the
anyone
camels?
See the camels? Where? I can't see them.
You have to say
hello.
Where?
Okay.
Oh, we can't see any real camels
just
yet. They're not ready yet. So some more. Just keep imagining. Keep imagining.
Where? Over here? Under here? Where? Oh, there they are! Let's welcome the camels, everyone.
Why does no one ever take us seriously?
I know! Are people laughing at us?
We are meant to be doing the serious bit.
So when your days are over and you rest with your ancestors,
I will raise up your offspring to succeed you, your own flesh and blood, and I will establish his kingdom.
He is the one who will build a house for my name, and I will establish the throne of his kingdom forever.
Thank you.
shopping list. You're joking.
You've lost it. Tell me you're joking.
So, the cabulator.
Hi, it's me. I'm the problem. It's me.
Well, this is a massive setback.
Come on, it can't be that hard to remember everything.
Are you serious? You forget your pants every single time, and I'm not lending you mine again.
Fair enough. I suppose we need to bring this king gift. What on earth do you bring the savior of the world?
Chocolate? Or to be honest, I always go with Orlando's voucher.
But what if they're vegan? We don't really know much about this messiah.
Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign.
The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son.
He will be called Emmanuel.
Did you hear that? A baby. Babies don't eat Nando's.
Well, the lemon and herb dressing is probably okay. Guys, once again, I've got this sorted out already. I've been on Amazon and I've chosen gifts on your behalf and written out birthday cards for you both to give. That's actually quite irritating.
Yeah, my mum does that sort of stuff all the time. So embarrassing.
Fine, well, what gifts have you brought us to give him then?
Okay, well, he's a king, right? So I will be giving him gold. What, like a golden dummy or a golden milk bottle?
Nope, just a solid lump of gold. What's a baby gonna do with that?
I don't know, just sort of lick it, I guess? Anyway, it's symbolic, okay? Gold is for a king. It was expensive. Ooh, let's have a look at this shiny gold bar then.
The production team said they don't have enough budget for me to show you a real one. So we got this.
Fair enough. What am I giving then?
Frankincense.
Frank who? Ah, that's what they use for worship and we're worshipping the king. I get it.
Dare I ask, what gift am I supposed to be giving him?
Ah, yes. Yours is great. A Black Friday deal too. You will be giving him myrrh.
Myrrh?
Ah, yes. That's what they put on rotting dead bodies.
Worst gift for a baby ever. So let me get this straight. You got yourself an actual block of gold to give him. You're giving him Frankenstein or whatever it is. And you got me something to give him that you sprinkle over dead bodies to a baby. The most important baby ever. King of kings, a god on earth.
Again, you guys need to trust me on this. It's all symbolic. Anyway, we'd better get going. Long journey ahead. Don't want to be 2 weeks late. I'm glad this star's leading us. I'm useless with maps. Must remember my pants.
On their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them.
Until it stopped over a place where the child was.
When they saw the star, they were overjoyed.
Wow, weren't those carols amazing? Why don't we stand and we're going to have our next carol. Why don't we stand?
Come, let us adore.
you take a seat, we're going to continue with our nativity.
Well, hasn't it been great so far? Who's enjoying it? Give me a thumbs up if you're enjoying it. Oh yeah, there we go. I love a bit of crowd participation.
Now, we're just here to sort of fill a little bit of time as a few things get set up behind us, but Lizzie, you're quite good at jokes, aren't you?
Yeah, well, I actually prepared some. So are we ready? What do you call Santa when he stops moving? Santa paws. How about this one? What do snowmen eat for dessert? Not quite. Ice Krispies.
Oh, that was bad.
Thanks to my help back here for sourcing me these.
Give us one more, maybe two more.
Oh, two more. Okay. Okay, I feel like this is a cracker classic. Okay, so I hope to hear some people shout this out. What do you get when you cross a snowman with a vampire?
Oh.
Yeah, frostbite.
Hey, oh, very good. Very good. Okay, well, there's a few things. Oh, the camels are back. They've been reinflated. That's good to see. Just going on, I think we've got... Oh, yep, okay. I think we might need another joke, Lizzie.
Oh, we need one more joke. What did the wise men say after they offered up their gifts of gold and frankincense? Wait, there's myrrh.
That was the worst one yet.
Yeah. It was. That really got a...
Oh. Well, we've done pretty good. I don't know. Should we just have a quick vote? Favourite part of the Christmas meal?
Yeah.
Hands up, stuffing. Favorite. Who goes for the stuffing first? Ooh, yeah, that's pretty good.
Some Brussels sprouts. Who loves a Brussels sprout? Yeah. Your family don't afterwards, obviously, but...
Yorkshire puddings.
Yorkshire puddings.
A few people at the back. Good engagement. And what else? Gravy?
Gravy?
Gravy.
Gravy. Almost the best part.
Oh. Oh, we need to get off. Let's continue the story.
For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given.
And the government will be on his shoulders.
And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace.
Reassuring. Thank you, Star of Wonder.
Wow, this is amazing. The camel sickness is so real, but it's totally worth the journey. I mean, look at him. I don't think I've seen anything more beautiful in my life.
Hello, it's so nice to see you. We have travelled from far away to see you and to celebrate you. We have some gifts for you. I've brought gold because we are ready for you to be our king.
Frankincense, because we will worship you, our saviour.
And I've brought myrrh. Well, actually, honestly, I don't know what it means, but it covers up bad smells, apparently.
Thank you very much, wise men.
Well, thank you, and we thank God for this gift too. Wonderful for words.
Glory to God in the highest heaven. On peace on earth, on those on whom in favour rest.
Oh.
party, do you think there'll be any nibbles? I'm quite hungry.
Parties make me nervous. So many new people to talk to. I always say the wrong thing.
Oh, there's nothing to it. Just be friendly. Here, let's start off with saying hi to the animals, of which for some reason there are a lot of at this party. Quite odd. Anyway, hello sheep. Hello cows, nice to meet you.
Oh, okay. Hello donkeys, hope you're having a nice day.
And I guess since we're doing the rounds, it's only fair we acknowledge our faithful camel friends.
Joking? Is that really what they think we sound like?
I told you no one ever takes us seriously.
Okay, seems like they've got the hump about something.
Hey, looks like there's some shepherds here. Let's see how they're doing. Hey guys, how was your journey following the star?
Oh, we didn't use the star.
We got told by an angel and made our way here.
Yeah, what took so long? I thought you were wise men.
Well, this is embarrassing.
So they didn't even have a star, but they still got here before us?
Yes, but they did have an angel. I bet he told them exactly where to find this place.
No, it was easy peasy.
Well, at least we brought gifts with us, so maybe that's something the shepherds might feel sheepish about.
That's a bad joke.
Yes, he ought to be ashamed of himself.
That's a donkey. Shepherds don't have donkeys.
Oh, okay. Well, maybe we should move on.
I've got one. So, a horse goes into the stable where the saviour of the world has just been born, and Mary says, "Why the long face?"
See, that was pretty good. You're getting into the party mood. That's probably the best joke ever told at a Christmas party.
What's Christmas?
Dunno, just made it up, like Christ's celebration. I think it'll catch on. People will be celebrating this event for the rest of time.
In that case, we should probably spend some more time with the Messiah instead of talking to each other and staring at the wall.
Yes, good point.
When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told to them about this child.
And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds had said to them.
Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart.
The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet.
The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel.
Friends, I think they need a bigger round of applause for that. We did it! Oh my goodness. Oh, I'm relieved. Don't know about you. How great. Keep going. Keep clapping. They were incredible. Scene one, scene two, scene three. Friends, you were amazing. I should be having a stand coming up, but it'll come up. Guys, I have a question for you. What is the greatest gift you've ever received? Is it a new bike? Or a brand new Elsa dress? Or shiny gold nail polish? Or a Lego set? Or here's one for the adults. A quiet Christmas with no tantrums? Yeah, I think we agree. Gifts make up so much of the Christmas that we know. We bend over backwards to spend probably too much money on presents for one another, all waiting in return for the perfect gift. If I was to ask any of you kids, I guarantee that most of you would say your favorite part of Christmas is the presents. Yeah, maybe. Yeah, we're getting some nods. Who remembers that John Lewis advert a few years ago when the little boy, dressed as the Gruffalo, came running so excited into his parents' bedroom, excited to give them the present? More excited to give the present than to receive. Gift giving and receiving makes up so much of Christmas. But have you ever had that completely heart-sinking moment when you're given a gift by someone with such joy and you open it and you don't like it one bit? Anyone had that? Oh, thank you so much. Anyone had that? A couple. Well, one of my favorite things about Christmas was working in a clothes shop. The buzz, the festive feel, the Christmas music that obviously started in October. It was amazing being part of making that Christmas perfect for people. There were wives, husbands, kids, sisters, brothers, you name it, coming in to buy that quintessentially British fashion that this shop had to offer. But everyone, the most hilarious part, and I'm not even kidding, were the few weeks that followed Christmas, where, no word of a lie, you had wives upon wives upon wives upon wives all returning the presents that their husbands had tried so hard, bless them, to get right, but had completely got wrong. The wrong size, fit, style, everything, completely wrong. In the staff room, we would chat and share stories of these complete fails that these husbands had made while trying so hard to get their wife's gifts right. There was also this Christmas, and I'm saying years ago, when my uncle so proudly gave me this hideous, tiered, tie-dye, itchy top thing. I actually have no idea what he was thinking. And friends, I cried so much. My mum even said to me, "Hannah, try it on. It will look so much better on." It didn't. It did not. Nothing can make this top look any better. And so every single Christmas since, in fact, probably this Christmas, my uncle will tell the story of a young, traumatized Hannah who was so unsure of what to do with such a terrible present that she cried. But we still do it to ourselves. We set ourselves up with excitement, with uncertainty and worry as we choose to trust our loved ones to get us the perfect gift. And that's where we are today. We're waiting, counting down the days, opening the advent calendar doors one at a time, eating the chocolates in the advent calendar one at a time, waiting for the big day to see what's going to be under the Christmas tree. We're decorating the house, buying in the food. We are inviting family round. We're doing all sorts to prepare ourselves as we are waiting and waiting and waiting for Christmas Day. But everyone, what if I told you that actually we're waiting for a gift that's already been given? Listen, the wise men, they were the ones waiting, living life, looking up into the stars, waiting. They had no idea when that big star was going to appear. The anticipation filling them full of longing of what was to come, living in the mystery and the hope. So you can understand the excitement when that star appeared in the sky. It's written in the Bible that someone years before had said that when that big star appeared in the sky, that meant that a king had been born. But they knew that that king wasn't just going to be any king. That king was going to be king of the world, king for us. And so the wise men packed up their gifts. They packed all their stuff. And didn't they pack some weird gifts? I think it was super strange, but everyone, I want to tell you that these gifts were clues to tell us more of who that baby was going to be and what he was going to do for us. Okay, gold. Gold, because what else do you give to a king but a solid lump of gold, right? But this king was special. He was unlike any other king. He was the biggest and the best that this world was ever going to see. He had all the power, but also was full of love. He was almighty, but fully knows you. He was a king that would rule, but also put us, his people, first. So we, when we're stuck in the ups and the downs of life, we can surrender to a king that truly knows us, that doesn't just sit on a throne and look down, but joins us in our lives, in our situations, and really knows us. We're safe in the presence of that almighty king, known, loved, and cared for. And what was next? Can I remember? Well, yes, it's a weird word. Can you remember? Frankincense. Yes, bit of a strange one. It was like a smell, kind of like a candle. Frankincense was used in the early, early Bible days. It was used to help people worship God. People were expecting a king. That bit wasn't a surprise. But a king that came and knew us, a king that didn't just leave us on our own, but came down to be near, to sit with us in the mess and the chaos, the growing energy bills, the wet school runs, the busy schedules, and that moment on Christmas Day at the Christmas dinner table when everything's been going pretty well and then Uncle Frank says something absolutely ridiculous. Jesus brings peace to every situation as he holds us and loves us so fully. And finally, anyone? Yes. Myrrh, again, weird. This had such a strong smell and it was used to put over people's bodies when they died to, you know, make it smell a little bit nicer than rotting dead body. But I, to be honest, share the complete shock that Wise Man 3 had. It was a weird present, but it points forward to something wonderful, something Jesus was going to do for us. The myrrh shows us that that baby didn't stay a baby, that he grew up and he came to love and heal and renew all people. And when he grew up, he saved us by dying on a cross and rising again. That was his mission on this earth. That was the reason he was born, to be our savior, so we can find full security in him. And just as that gift came to them, to the wise men that day, it's ready for us to receive today, now, where we are. Because these gifts reveal to us that this baby was the greatest gift. It tells us that this baby was a king who came down to be with us so we can worship him and who saves us. This gift was given to us by the greatest gift giver of all time, God. And so whatever is going on in our lives right now, Jesus is the greatest gift, the perfect gift, in fact, a gift that will never disappoint us. It will never let you down. It's reliable and unbreakable. Nothing like that terrible tie-dye top my uncle gave me all those years ago. And absolutely 100% different to any gift you're gonna receive under the Christmas tree this Christmas. This gift of Jesus is forever and has been waiting for you. This gift is Jesus. And as you follow him, he will fill you with his love, his joy, his peace, and his hope. This gift looked like a baby, but on the inside, underneath the wrapping, he was the greatest gift, and now he's here waiting for you. And so, I have a question for you. This Christmas, what would you like Jesus to do in your world and in our world? This Christmas. Can I pray for us? God, I thank you so much that you sent Jesus to bring to us in our situations your love, your joy, your peace, and your hope. And God, I thank you that you are still here with us. And Jesus, you are ready to answer our prayers as we answer this question. Amen.
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 Now, we're gonna take this as an opportunity to respond, aren't we? So why don't you talk us through what you'd like us to do?
Yes, see, one of the gifts in the story was the star to the wise man. And so what we're gonna do today is, in just a moment, people are gonna come around. In fact, they're gonna start now. They're gonna be handing out crayons and pens and stars to each one of you. So everyone, adults, you too, each get a star. And we would love you to write on those stars the answer to that question. What would you like Jesus to do in your world and our world this Christmas?
Great, so the team are gonna begin, so I think they already are, but do grab a star, grab a crayon, grab a pen, and maybe if you're with your little one, why don't you sit with them and ask them that question. What would you like to see Jesus do in your life and in the world around you? And so we're gonna do this as sort of a big family. I know it's chaos, but it's great. So we're gonna take a few moments, grab a star, grab a pen and crayon, and then after that, once you've written down, what do you want us to do, Hannah?
After you've written down on the stars, there are four black boards. I think there's one at the back, one here, one there, and one over there, I think. I think maybe one over there as well. Have a look what the nearest one is to you. And we would love you to bring your star and pin it up on the boards.
Great, so once you've got your pen and crayon written down what you'd like Jesus to do, as you can see, the blackboard's like Hannah said, and begin to do this. Why don't we do this? The band are going to play for us, and this is our response today.
Love me, I pray.
if you finish with your stars, why don't you return to your seats and stand, and we're gonna have another song.
Phenomenal. Amazing. Thank you so much.
Well done. Amazing costumes as well. All the parents, Blue Peter badges. Well done.
Blue Peter badges all round.
We want to give everyone an opportunity to respond to what Hannah said. Obviously, we've been given the greatest gift in Jesus. And one of the ways we respond to that is by giving. And this Christmas, our giving at St. Peter's is going towards supporting three amazing charities that are at work in our city.
One are some food banks that we're supporting. One in
White Hawk and one in Hollandine, feeding people at a time of need. So that's one of the...
And then the other one is Project Antifreeze, that's run by Off the Fence. Project Antifreeze is an amazing initiative that meets people experiencing homelessness right at the point of need, in practical ways, in emotional ways, and with advice, and loads of other ways as well. And we are going to be supporting them this Christmas. So if you would like to give to either of those, you can do so by texting all the details on the screen.
Get out your phones now.
Yeah. You text 70580, that's the number to text to, and what you do is you write the word St. Peter's as one word, followed by the number you want to give. So if you want to give £5, you would text to 70580 St. Peter's 5.
If you want to give a tenner, then you would do St. Peter's 10.
And then if you want to give
A billion pounds.
Okay, you text St. Peter's, followed by, I don't know how many zeros that is, but if you have a billion, you probably do. But anything you want to give, it makes a massive difference, is going to those who need it the most this Christmas.
Yeah, so get out your phones now and text if you want to give.
The other
Thank
way,
you so much.
Two other ways we just want to flag that you might want to respond. If today has piqued your curiosity and you want to continue to explore the Christmas story, Alpha is a great way to explore the big questions of life. Alpha begins January the 18th, next term. Food, talk, discussion.
It's just a great way to kick off your new year, talking about the things that matter and exploring the meaning of life. So definitely get that in the diaries.
And
so
you'll be offered a Why Christmas and a leaflet about Alpha as you leave. And then most importantly...
Finally!
This is the beginning!
This is the beginning
of Christmas! This is our first service. There are loads of services. You can find out all the details on this card.
Next week, CAROLS, 4 p.m., 6 p.m. and 8 p.m. Kids, bring your parents to the 4 p.m. That's the one that we're encouraging
children to. Bring
your
adults to the 4 p.m. next week. The CAROLS going to be off the chain. Then the week after that, we have...
Christingle.
What is a Christingle?
Oranges, sweets, everything and fire. Everything pointing to the story of Jesus in an edible way.
And then Christmas Day, tell us what's happening.
It's going to be all a joy. Christmas Day, 10 a.m. in this room, come in your pyjamas, is the perfect time.
Or your onesies.
Or
Christmas
jumpers.
You've
woken up at 5 a.m. with the presents. It's now 10 a.m. You're here letting the kids burn off some energy, ready to get home and eat turkey. It's going to be fun. It's going to be music. It's going to be dance. It's going to be drama. It is going to be a party. So Christmas Day in here, we would love to celebrate with you. Let's celebrate Jesus.
And so we're going to finish now by singing Joy to the World. So let's welcome the band back. And yeah, let's remain standing. Thanks for coming. See you next week.
Joy to the world.
Joy to the world, the Lord.
we will sing joy.